All right, so we've looked at the logical and that works for situations where two or more things have to be true in order for the output to be true. But sometimes we just want one thing or the other to be true in order for the output to be true. And there's those type of situations that lend themselves to what we call an or, a logical or. And as I was trying to think of an example, I was thinking about back in my dating life. Before I got married, in that life, which by the way is a pretty miserable life, isn't it? I guess there's fun moments in there, but there's a lot of misery to get to those fun moments. But a good process nonetheless, right? It worked out well in my case, and so in those days, I was getting older and older and older relative to the dating population, and I became kind of aware of this, and I, you know. There began to be a question when people, it seemed like everybody wanted to set me up, right? Blind dates. And they'd say, you really ought to go out with this person. And one of my first questions was, well, how old are they? Because are they going to think I'm, a creepy old man or something? Well, in those types of situations, let's say we're writing some dating software. And so we're going to get some information for this dating software. We're going to get, So I'm going to go in and build a scanner. In equals new scanner system dot in. Okay, and then in order to do that, I'm going to need to import my Java dot util dot scanner class. Okay, so I've got that imported, and then I'm going to create two variables: one a string for the name, and I'll set that equal to blank to begin with. I'll initialize that to blank. And then an int for age. Okay, and I'll set the age equal to 0 to begin with. Now we're going to ask the user for that information. So we're going to ask user to enter name and age for this dating software. Okay, so system.out.println. Please enter your name. And then we're going to read that in. Name equals in dot next line to read in that name. And then we'll get the age. So system.out.println. How old are you? And then read that in. So age equals in dot what? Well, it's an integer, so it's going to be a next int. Okay, so now we've got that information that we can make a decision on. Now, the way that I see this work, and this is probably just in my mind, let's say decide whether this person is dateable. Is that a word? Okay, so these examples are so stupid. But you try coming up with examples. It's not that easy. Okay, so we're going to say if. Now I'm going to predetermine an age. And so let's say for this particular dating software, I'm saying if in my mind I'm thinking, oh no, if I get to 40, then no one will ever want to date me, let's say. Now, not that there's anything wrong with 40, but I'm just saying in my mind, maybe that's the way it was. So I say if age is less than 40, then system.out.println, I will date you. Okay? Else, system.out.println. Sorry, you're out of luck. Okay, so that's the dating restriction that a person of a certain age might set there. Now we could make this a variable too, because it's going to vary from person to person, right? And from age to age. And so we could even say, well, let's leave it like that. That'll be less confusing. But with the idea that obviously 40 wouldn't be that big of a deal if you were 39, right? And so, and not that it's a big deal anytime. I can already see the comments coming on this video. This is just made up stuff here. I'm trying to do an example. Chill out. Okay, so we'll go ahead and compile this, and then we'll say, what's your name? Well, my name's Spencer. And how old are you? Well, I'm, 42. And it says, sorry, you're out of luck. And as long as I'm beneath that age, so Spencer, and the age is, let's say, 25, I will date. You know, we probably ought to have an and in here. Because what if the age was like four? This, okay, let's try it. This will be, okay. Please enter your name. It's Spencer. How old are you? I am 4 years old. I will date you. Okay. Okay. Back to the example at hand. Where I was going with this is I kind of saw this in my dating, that if age is less than 40, then sorry, you're out of luck. Or sorry, if it's greater than 40, sorry, you're out of luck. But there was an exception, right? It is, if age is less than 40, I will date you. Or the name dot equals Brad Pitt. Okay. So if one of those conditions is true or the other, then the response is, I will date you. And so we can try this. I can say, please enter your name. My name is Brad Pitt. And how old are you? Well, I'm, 60. I will date you. That's the response. Even though this condition wasn't true, this condition was true. And because one or the other is true, then the output is true. Okay, so where we had and I didn't even cover it. See, I got a little ahead of myself here. When we're doing a logical or, the way we represent that is two bars. And the bar is a lot of times represented on a keyboard as two vertical lines. One like hyphens stacked on top of each other and pointing down. Well, that was a horrible way to describe that. But it's usually shift something somewhere near the backspace key. And if we hold down shift and press that bar, then what we get is this. Okay, so two bars is an or. And that's what we've done in this situation. In our if statement, we say, if the age is less than 40, or, okay, again, that represents an or, the name equals Brad Pitt, then the response is, I will date you. Otherwise, if it's anything else, if it's not one or the other, then I'm going to say, sorry, you're out of luck. Okay? And then we could put even in more. We could say, or name equals, whoever. We could add in another name, Tom Cruise. Well, if the name equals Brad Pitt or Tom Cruise or the age is less than 40, then I will date you. Okay, and we can try this by saying Tom Cruise is the name. How old are you? 101. I will date you. Because this condition was true, and they're all tied together with ors, and as long as one of those conditions is true, the output is true. And that's an or statement. Now, the only other thing I'd add is if we have an and an or all in the same statement, just like there's an order of operations in math where we have, multiplication and division come before addition and subtraction. If we put all of the statements into one if statement, ands and ors, and there's no parentheses showing precedence one way or another, then the and takes precedence over the or. So it'll look at the ands first and attach them together and then look at the ors. And so that's just an important thing when you're putting it all together. My personal preference is just always use parentheses to, even though it doesn't necessarily need them, it just makes it more clear and in my mind helps eliminate errors. But that's a logical or. And then the other one that we talked about already in a previous lecture was the not. The exclamation point equals a not, and we can add a not onto anything. We can say if it's not an age less than 40, and that will reverse the meaning, right? We can say if the name, if it's not the situation that the name is Brad Pitt, then that can reverse that logic as well. But what that means is we have to be careful with the nots, because that means if I enter any name besides Brad Pitt, so I enter a name, Spencer, and how old are you? 52. It will say, I will date you, even though I was over the age of 40, because the name was not equal to Brad Pitt. And because this isn't an or, that's true. The name isn't equal to Brad Pitt. And so this one's true, even if these ones are false. And so it still says, I will date you, because the name is not equal to Brad Pitt. If we want to say, we just have to be careful. Let me just put it that way. We want to be careful whenever we throw a not in there, because usually it means we need to switch from an or to an and in our logic. And now I've just confused you. So forget about that for a minute. But what I just wanted to point out that we have three logical operators, an and, an or, and a not. And the and is represented by two ampersands, the or is represented by two bars, and the not is represented by an exclamation point. And we can use those to have multiple conditions in an if statement. All right? Okay. Spencer out.